Bangladesh, the movements of that idealistic bastion Bengal was your main inspiration, it seemed. Could you start with that period, and how important is it still today, and how did it move you forward in your life? And why poetry first and foremost?
You know, people feel that they want to do something with their lives. And very often, they walk a particular way. I began my life choosing to write. And the most important part of writing that I enjoyed most was poetry. I came from a city, a culture, a background, my parents were school teachers, where literature was, creativity was everywhere. I remember the first time, I must have been 15 or 16 when I knocked on Satyajit Ray's door and walked, and we had a conversation that lasted 4 hours. I remember the first time we went to Jyoti Basu, or at the Calcutta Coffee House, and we discussed politics. I was 17. I remember the first time I met Hussein, who was passing through. I was 16, and he sat and had a huge, long conversation about art. So the engagement with the arts, with culture, begins very early in that city, and it's not formalized. So people do it as it comes naturally to them. I wanted to write. I wanted to be a poet. So I gave up everything to do that. It seems absurd to say that today when I look back on it. But I finished schooling and went to Presidency College, which was a very popular college at that time. I was what you may as well call the first class of Naxalites, the first class that bred the first generation of young boys, highly educated, extremely gifted, talented young men who chose to go to Naxalbari and seek an understanding of why some people are so poor in this country, while others are so well off. It was not about politics. We tend to see everything in terms of politics today. It was about hope. It was about dreams. It was about trying to create a new social order. Heroes of that time were people like, of my generation, were people like Che Guevara, John Lennon, colleagues, chucked it up and went to Nassau.